Wilderness Inquiry partners with North and Edison High Schools to provide outdoor education experiences.
We are at Fort Snelling State Park, and today we're here with the ninth grade from North High School, and we are doing four different place-based educational stations. One is a Voyageur fur traders game, water quality testing, and learning about invasive species. Another is fishing, and then we're also canoeing on Snelling Lake.
We wanted to take the kids out to experience some nature, and we wanted to get them doing things that they probably haven't done before.
This is my first time catching fish.
When we went fishing, they taught us how to cast out and how to double hook the worm on the hook.
And hold one side.
It was super fun. I actually touched a worm for the first time. It was really cool. I know that's not like really big to a lot of people, but to me it is because I'm really scared of bugs.
Caterpillar, which
and I found a calipator. That was really fun.
So even though they only live a few miles from here, they probably haven't spent a lot of time at many state parks or doing a lot of outdoor activities like we've had them do today. So I think that's a really important thing, that Wilderness Inquiry offers those equal opportunities so every kid can experience the outdoors.
We were all thinking, like, we're city kids. And like, you could kind of tell that we don't normally come around this nature, so we all kind of learned how to like adapt to a situation and adapt to an environment that we're not used to.
It's about introducing the whole concept to kids and hoping they'll grow that love for their surroundings.
Well, they are very curious because a lot of them are a little bit more unfamiliar with the place that we brought them today and unfamiliar with some of the experiences that they've been doing. So they've been asking a lot of questions. They've been, you know, really interested in kind of getting to know what we're doing here. So we've done some canoeing. We're about to do some water sampling where they're looking at what kind of things live in the water. It ties in really nicely with science, with biology, what we're studying right now, with ecology. What are the components of an ecosystem? And how do we know how that ecosystem is functioning well? Is it polluted or isn't it polluted? And what's the quality of it? The kids have also done some fishing, which they had a great time doing. They even caught some fish. So that was kind of a cool thing for them. And we also played a game learning a little bit about how the French voyagers and the Dakotas were interacting, you know, way back in time at this same location at Fort Snelling, the things that they were trading and some historical things to tie in. So we really hit a lot of the content areas with this trip, not just science.
And when we were at trading, that was like actually my favorite part because we got to like talk funny and we were like cheering and stuff. And then we danced. I really liked that. That was really fun.
Anytime you can get kids excited and wondering about things and just getting in there and doing stuff that they normally don't do, that's a skill that you bring back to the classroom, and you know, hopefully they will carry that skill of wanting to be inquirers and wanting to be curious in all areas of their life.
It's cold in the winter time, so you need some protection. So
these are the future stewards of our planet, but it's not an opportunity that everyone has, so we're making that available to these kids, showing them that these parks belong to them, doing also some environmental education, and trying to tie in with their curriculum at school as well.
And by the end of the day, on the bus ride home, they're gonna be talking about how much fun they had. And they're gonna talk about it for a long time afterwards. Oh, do you remember when we did this at Fort Snelling? Anytime an experience happens to them, it stays with them. You know, more so than, you know, reading an article about it or something. They're out here and they're doing it, and they're gonna remember it forever. It's gonna make them a global citizen. It's gonna prepare them for a lot of other things in life.
To learn more about science education at MPS, visit science.mpls.k12.mn.us.